Hello everyone and welcome to another video tutorial. Today we are going to build calculator using GUI. So let's get started. Type guide in your command window. So you'll see a guide quick start. Click on blank GUI. Press OK. Now in the layout, all you are going to need is push buttons and an edit box. So click on push buttons and arrange them in the manner shown. And take edit box. Place it over here. So here is the final layout for calculator. Name the push buttons as shown in the figure only, and do not forget to change the tags in the property inspector. So now let's run the calculator figure. So here is the layout you'll see after running the original code. Now the next thing is to write the callback functions for all the push buttons. So right click, view callbacks. Click on callback. So I have already written this code for you guys. As you can see in the callback for push button 0, we have extracted all the handles to a variable named string and converted it into format string. Since the push button is going to have a constant value, that is either 0, 1 till 9, we are using handles.text1 instead of handles.edit1 since we won't be editing it. And as you go along the line, you can see that we have done similar for almost all the push buttons. So you can copy that code from our site. I'll paste a link for that in the video description down below. Now another thing you might notice is we have used the function string cat, that is concatenation of two strings, in the edit box, since we'll be concatenating the string of the push button to the previous value. And again setting the handles to text1 and converting them to string. So now run this program and see what happens. So here is the calculator from the layout. Now first of all we'll find the square root of a number. If it is 35, now we'll perform some basic arithmetic operations. Suppose 12 into 5 plus 3. So you can perform as many applications as you can as you do on the regular calculator. Here is another fun program, that is mouse pointer. So when I run this program, whenever I try to get into the layout of that particular area, I won't be able to get into it. Instead, the mouse pointer will be just thrown away. So let's see what happens. I'll run the program and whenever I try to get into the send me to different location area, my mouse pointer will just be randomly sent away to another position. So as you can see, I'm not getting into that area. So you can find such programs, such fun articles in our site matlabhelper.com. So I hope you guys liked the video. If you have any suggestion or thought, please leave it in the comment section down below. So that's it for today. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao for now.